For more on the impact of the ECQ on the private sector, we now have with us Ambassador Benedicto Yujuico, the President of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. I'm just wondering, as the government reimposes the lockdowns again in the NCR Plus area, how are large companies changing their tack so that they can cope better, or, you know, this ECQ won't be as disruptive as it was last year?
Most large manufacturing companies have implemented pandemic operational plans since the third quarter of 2020 and don't see any significant disruption for another, if in fact ECQ is for another week. A caveat though, they're gonna see increases in their shuttle expenses for their employees. But other than that, they're fine. The shared resources of big companies, HR, admin, personnel, accounting, etc., they have managed to do work from home. So they're okay with this. The only concern that they have, April, is if the government imposes a 50% capacity limit on their manufacturing or even on their operations, that would hurt. But otherwise, they are prepared for this.
So how would the latest lockdowns impact the recovery prospects for the year? Did they have to scale down on, say, their projections for the 2021 recovery?
For sure, the recovery prospects will definitely be delayed. You know, if you look at the data from the Department of Labor, you will see that the unemployment has been increasing. And, you know, last year, close to 5 million workers were affected, with 428,000 coming from 2,060 large firms. You know, NEDA also estimates that the two-week ECQ will shave off 0.8 percentage points from economic growth this year. Concretely, this means a loss of additional 252,000 jobs, income loss of 30 billion, and 102,000 more Filipinos are going to be moved into poverty.
And can the government do anything to ensure that recovery can be achieved right away?
There is no quick solution to ensure economic recovery. Our country needs a holistic plan and should explain in detail the recovery plan to everyone regarding vaccine, why the continuing use of face mask, face shield, and social distancing is important, the need for tracing, testing, and treatment using the big data approach, the construction of healthcare capacity relief for hospital frontliners, financial assistance to MSMEs, direct subsidies to the marginalized. That's very important. So government has to develop a plan. We need a master plan, and government needs to tell everybody what the plan is. That's what needs to happen.
And as far as the vaccine procurements are concerned, the president recently said that the private sector can procure these vaccines at will. In what way has, you know, the pronouncement of the president help the business community, or can we actually really bring in the vaccines?
We actually wrote to the president and requested the president to allow the private sector to import vaccines directly. And surprisingly, in the evening, the president on TV announced that he would allow private sector to import in whatever quantity they want, and he will instruct Secretary Galvez to sign any and all paperwork, et cetera, et cetera. However, the following day, we were informed by Secretary Galvez that the government is sticking to the procedures as called for by law, which is we have to get into a tripartite agreement. We have to follow certain procedures. So I wrote to him, to Secretary Galvez. I said, please let us know, what are the IRRs? In other words, what does the private sector specifically need to do in order to import vaccines directly. So far, I haven't gotten an answer.
What about the CREATE law? Should this help smoothen out the recovery?
It will help, definitely. It will reduce taxes for big corporations. But again, CREATE is not enough. You know, there are things that we need to do. We need to help. We need to really, really help our MSMEs so that they can continue to keep the employment, because we are really worried that the lines for the ayuda are getting too long and people have to wait 12 hours to get their 1,000 or 4,000 per household. So it's not just CREATE alone. It's a holistic approach that we have to implement. It's not like, it's the same as saying, hey, if we lock it down, it's not going to solve our problem. It's lockdown plus many other things developed into a master plan, which the government should implement.
Speaking of the master plan, in the private sector, what are your suggestions for the government to achieve the master plan for recovery?
You know, the private sector has always been, I consider us in the private sector as always ready, willing, and able to help the government. For example, in terms of even basic dissemination of information, we believe the private sector will be of great help convincing the people that vaccines are safe. We try to engage the government as well on other types of possible prophylaxis cures that we should study very thoroughly, because we have seen so many people swearing up and down that this particular medicine has cured them. So government should engage. Government should try to react quicker, I think, because private sector is 24 hours ready, willing, and able to help them in any way that we can.
Is the private sector so far satisfied with the government response, or, you know, more can be done?
Specifically, I will request sana, if possible, for us to be getting quicker response to our suggestions, comments, and also we hope that they will be much clearer in terms of what we in the private sector will be allowed to do. For example, I have to go back to the importation of vaccine. There is no clear guideline as of now. So even if I wanted to, or somebody wanted to, we can't even begin the process, because the first thing the supplier will ask us is, all right, do you have your government support for this purchase? And if we don't have a clear support from the government that they're allowing it, we cannot get anywhere. So we are requesting sana to, for the specifically Secretary Galvez to be very clear, so private sector knows how to proceed consistent with the requirements of the law.
In November, the market rallied strongly because there was hope that, you know, we're seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. At this point where, you know, we see infections going up and the government having to reimpose ECQ, do you still see that light at the end of the tunnel, or, you know, it's becoming dimmer?
Ay, nako, April. The light at the end of the tunnel is still there. But the problem is that with the recent resurgence of infections and lockdowns, we seem to be moving away from instead of towards the end of the tunnel. Yun ang problema. Nakita natin, pero umatras ata tayo imbis na umaabante. That is my concern.
Well, I hope that we will finally realize that, you know, we need to turn around and move towards the light so that we will get to the end of the tunnel.
Yes, private sector is here to help, April. So anytime the government calls us, 24 hours, we will be ready to assist.
Okay, with that, thank you very much, Ambassador Yujuico, and stay safe.
Okay, thank you, and stay safe too. Bye-bye.